bands and everything. So I'm gonna bet. See, does this guy play Lulu? He doesn't. He does play Lulu, so I'm gonna leave it open. So I'm gonna ban. I'll ban whatever. It doesn't matter. There's no specific ban for top lane right now, so. I think the op.gg is here. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I can do that. So you guys can follow up with me and everything. Alright, so far they have a team of. They have Jhin and they have Leona. Very poor composition already from them. So far, Riven seems to be like the best one to pick, but I can still see their next two picks, so I can even tell you right after this. You don't have aspiration when you're challenging a lot of players. If you're going to get into the pro scene, from what you know of. I've gotten offers to go in the LCS, but like the academy teams and everything. I just don't want to. So we're going against Vladimir. Yeah, Riven's definitely like the best one this game. Let me see what they pick here. Zed? Oof! Riven is beautiful here. Oh my god. Riven is fucking amazing this game. She's like the best one for this game. We're gonna go Domination. We're gonna go Sudden Impact. We're gonna go here. We're gonna go for the 10%. And we're gonna go for Nullifying Orb. Actually, just for Vladimir, nah, we'll go Scorch. We're gonna pop off this game. So the reason this game is perfect for Riven is that their champions are very immobile in terms of like Jhin, Leona, Vladimir. It's hard for them to get out. My CC helps me kill the Zed pretty easily, helps me peel. I have pretty good disengage against their team. I have really good mobility to avoid their skill shots, and you know, I can just stomp throughout this lane. It's really, really good. Basically, for example, that last game, if you don't dodge games like that, you will lose games way more. You need to. It's just a matter. The dodging tool, or just dodging in general, is underused a lot for ranked and everything because people don't want to wait the 5 minutes extra. They're like, oh no, man, maybe this guy will do good. You're getting game, and the guy fucking feeds his ass off, and you automatically lose the game. That's the worst feeling you can have. Alright, let's take a look at the enemy team OP.gg, see who do I have to focus on the enemy team, to see who's actually good on their team. So let's take a look. Live game. So they have no smurfs. They have Jhin, Leona has the highest win rate. The Zed has a 21% win rate. The Kha'Zix has 48% and the Vladimir has 44%. So the one I have to watch out for in the enemy team right now is the Vladimir. Good enough. He's on my lane, so I can just stomp him through and then the game should be all over automatically. Do you go electric because you're smurfing or testing? I do electrocute in matchups where I can stomp super easily. Right now, I like electrocute, it's not bad. Electrocute, but you is way more skilled than NA. They're both the same. I got a challenger in both regions. They're like ish. I mean, it's a little less skilled. So when you're playing this matchup against Vladimir and you or champions like Vladimir and Loilo and you want to stomp super hard, like I said, you gotta cheese early. It's really good to cheese. So for example, he's gonna go all the way around, and the way I'm gonna just pop off. I don't have to worry that much about this jungle interaction with Kha'Zix. Kha'Zix, while he's a strong champion, if Riven's above like 80% HP, Riven should never die to the Kha'Zix. The way he's playing up like that makes me think that Kha'Zix is here or near, so gotta be careful. He just uses W so I can potentially kill him. I'm cool with dying here, I don't mind. Because the wave is pushing back to me, and now what I can do is I freeze this wave that's coming in. I freeze it here, and the Vladimir, every single time he tries to do anything to me, he automatically dies every single time. So this is a very good, this is like how you use wave advantage to carry the game. So I'm gonna TP here, and now the wave, I'm gonna keep it here the entire time. So the Vlad, I already lost the game based on this. Start Orange Shield, sit back, make sure to like not get cheesed by that brush by either warding it or walking down around this side of the lane. You can't walk as a ranged top laner if you don't see the enemy Riven into like right next to the brush there, because you get killed. You get cheesed pretty hard. can get a dust bud. Why do you lock your screen? I use spacebar to go back to my screen. Sell this. Let's get that. And two word. Our word. Yeah, I won't get two. I'll just get one. All this only because level 1 cheese. Interesting. You gotta do that every game when you're playing low elo. They always fall for it every single time. In higher elo, most players don't fall for it. And even then, some of them do. Some challenger players still fall for it, though. I played against Flame a couple of weeks back, if you remember. He was playing GP or Vlad, I remember. He walked through this brush and died level 1. Even pro players fuck it up from time to time. I plan on pushing this wave here, I plan on letting it push back to me. If the Vladimir pops up, I can kill him. If I keep pushing, he gets a chance to farm and not die, so I'm gonna wait and see what the Vladimir wants to do. Got it. I ulted just because I wanted to get the tower beforehand, before they finish the tower mid lane. Alright, let's go back, get another lethality. Actually, yeah, I'll go pure lethality this game. Sounds like a plan. Interesting. This shouldn't be happening, but I'll carry against it. At least I'll try. I use TP to help other lanes. Usually you want to use it in a very greedy way and just to be able to, whenever you're trying to carry low elo games, you want to use it just to get yourself ahead a lot of the time, to get experience and everything. I can stop that tower from going down. Once I get my Yumus and I get Ninja Tabby and everything, I should be good. Everyone's dying way too much though, which is surprising, but it's okay. If I didn't, for example, this is one of those games where, like, if I didn't cheese the Vlad and I didn't get as ahead as I did, this game could potentially be a very easy loss to get, you know? So this is why you gotta be very aggressive in like the early levels while you're climbing. Very, very aggressive. Hey, Bronze Rare, thank you for the 20 bucks, man.
For such an educational stream. I learned a lot just from watching you keep up the good work, man.
I'm okay. Push normally. I know this isn't worth it because of this, so if the Kha'Zix come, I can kill him. If the Jhin comes, I can kill him as well. And this guy should be dead here. Interesting. This is actually not bad. Holy shit. Is that smurfing as well? Holy shit. I got pop. I need to get a black cleaver this game. This guy's way too fed right now. Yeah, this guy's smurfing too. Interesting, when I picked it up on the OPWG, they didn't show me that he was the one that's smurfing. Actually, he has like the worst win rate out of everything. He has four wins and 16 losses. Interesting. That's very odd. I didn't focus on his lane specifically because his win rate was so bad. Maybe he's getting boosted? Probably. I doubt it though. It's okay. It's very hard for their team to be able to carry with the comp that they have, so I'm not worried. If they had a comp that was actually like really, really good, I'd be really scared though. It would suck. The Kha'Zix and the Zed can be a huge problem for me. So I'm definitely going Black Cleaver this game from what I can see. I need the extra health and everything to survive whenever I'm dominating their team and team fights and everything. It's an interesting game because statistically what's happening right now shouldn't be happening. They're both dead down there. The Zed mechanically was playing not like a... Oh, wait. That's interesting. The fucking Nami killed him. What the fuck? I need to play according to where the Kha'Zix is, because the Kha'Zix is also playing very good, which is quite interesting. Let's go. If we get this Fire Drake, it'll be much easier for us to carry. Kha'Zix is such a problem. Wait, why did you ult him? What? This is low elo, Adrian. Unpredictability is key. Indeed, huh? It's okay. I'll try my hardest to win this game regardless. I have TP. Hopefully he doesn't die. Oh well. That's so odd he would die there. Let's keep pushing this and getting part of my Black Cleaver. We will probably lose that Drake and I can't do anything about it, which sucks. Actually, can we fight for that Drake, please? It's gone, huh? We can't. Shame. That Drake is super important. Help me out here. Keep chasing. Come on, go, 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 go. Now you have to watch out for the Kha'Zix as well. The Kha'Zix jumping in is the one I want to focus on. Where do you go? He jumped up. Let's get the bottom lane tower. Can you draw Fury game next? I do it based on what I have to, or on what's better against the enemy comp. For example, if I pick Camille, Riven, or anything, I mean Camille, Renex, or anything else this game, I automatically lose this game. Got the shutdown gold on him too. I have my Black Cleaver now. Now with Black Cleaver, I can dominate this game by myself. I still need my team to do half decent, but I'm able to carry this game. Alright, in this situation, I need to be the one split pushing bottom, because the only objective that's up is the Rift Herald, so I need to split push bottom, shove, and then roam middle with my team, and group with them and try to take that tower out with them. me out here, guys. Come on. Keep chasing. Oh, boys, come on. Exhaust? Holy shit. My team got manhandled so hard there. Jesus Christ. I need to not play with this team with adjusting to like skill shots and everything. I can't play with thinking that they're gonna actually get the kills and everything, or like get a skill shot in. I need to play according to knowing that they're gonna miss everything they try to do. Which is a shame. I don't like playing the game that way, but it's definitely gonna be the case this game. Split push game? Not split push game. More like roam catch. Roam catch game is the way we're gonna play it. The next dragon that's up is that Drake. Okay, keep going. So this game I'm gonna go one more lethality item, and then a GA. GA is very important for me this game. Even a stopwatch in its current state is really useful for me in this situation. Run. Need to dash out my way. Help me out. If he can land the knockup, would be great. Great job. I need to roam middle now and get the kills on the early carrying because my bot lane died. You need a death dance? Yeah, death dance would be good as well. But I plan on going for the next lethality item first, though. Next item, actually, I'm probably gonna get. I'm gonna get a lethality item and a stopwatch. Stopwatch is gonna be really useful for me for a team fight. Let's get this and a stopwatch. Super useful. My flash got me up in 10. That's like the key to winning this. Oh. Yep. Sun goes down, they have the Leona. You can see what I mean, but it's a pick and roam game. It's not a split push game per se. If you split push this game entirely, you automatically lose because they're just that you can't trust this team. So they don't have the mechanical ability to just like stay on their own. They need someone to protect them from bad play. And when teams do that, you need to stay with them at all times and make sure to erase their own positional errors throughout the whole match. interesting. I don't want to use my flash threat unless I have a team fight or something happening. Good job. My flash is very important this game for team fighting. Great job.